Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi, my name is Insayo Binti Ahmad, and now I will proceed my part of capital editing, which is additional considerations and post audit of investment project. First is the additional considerations. Additional consideration is actually the qualitative factor of decision making of this investment project. Instead of the quantitative factors, which is the NPV and IRR that always the manager using in any decision making, we also use this consideration in determining the investment budget. First, it have intangible benefits, and second is risk issues in capital budgeting. First, intangible benefits. Intangible benefits is actually include the increased quality, improve of safety, greater the employee loyalty, or more favorable social influence in the company proposal. It have two approach in estimate this intangible benefit, which is calculate NPV without looking to intangible benefit, and credit graph using the conservative estimates of the intangible benefit. First, that we have to know that calculate the NPV without looking to intangible benefit is actually if the NPV is positive, the company will accept the proposal, while it is negative, so the company will use this estimates, which is the conservative estimates of the intangible benefit, using this one. Includes the increase of the quality, improve of safety, and etc. Let's we take a look of the example of this intangible benefits, which is from the art company. In this art company have a discount rate of 15% of the estimated life of 10 years. And here we see that NPV is negative. So from what we have know, this negative amount can be resulting to the rejecting of the proposal. But if we use the second estimates that I've said earlier, if we assume that the company, the proposal will be increase of cash inflows in 8,000 ringgit, which are resulting in the improvement of quality and safety. Quality and safety. Cash outflow will reduce to 5,000, which resulting in any claims, for example, claims on injury. This will resulting to increase the NPV amount. This is the calculation of the estimates. Here we can see the amount will increase of the cash inflow of 8,000, and annual cash outflow will reduce to 20,000. So the NPV will become positive. So automatically the manager will approve this proposal and take it into account. Next is about risk issues in capital budgeting. In this, risk issues in capital budgeting is actually risk that arises due to the uncertainty with future financial results. This risk is refers to the extent or the likelihood of the project to not occur. And it has two categories of approach in dealing with the risk, which is assessing the level of risk and reacting the level of risk. In assessing the level of risk, it actually uses the sensitivity analysis, which uses a number of particular outcomes estimates to get a sense of variability among potential returns. The manager will examine key input values affecting the projects to see how the changes of the input that might be influenced the viability of the project. The key input factors is initial outlay of the machine, sales volume and selling price, relevant operating costs, life of the project, and financing costs. Let's take an example of Young Telecom of this assessing level of risk. Okay. Here, Young Telecom assume that Young Telecom want to improve the proposal, and the best estimates of the discount rate is 15%, which resulting the net present value of positive. Okay, here if we take a look into the sensitivity analysis, the manager will usually assume the number of discount rate, for example 25%. They want to see how sensitive it is through the NPV, through this net present value. Okay, let's assume that it is 25% of increase in the discount rate. Okay, this is the calculation of the 25% of the discount rate that resulting in negative NPV. So here, usually manager will use the IRR method to assume the sensitivity of the proposal. But here, in assessing the level of risk, we use the difference of the discount rate, which is 25% and 15%, which is the difference is 10%, and the net present value is positive. So it is a good so the manager will assume that this 10% is a good okay, it actually tells that this positive value tells that this company will this proposal will sustain or not. And then the change in 1% is calculated as 47,600 divided by 10, and you get the change. 1% of the discount rate of 4706. Next is reacting the level of freeze. In reacting the level of freeze, it's used the law of risk premium, which is the higher the level of risk, the greater the risk premium is demanded. It will add to the risk free rate of return to obtain the total return required. In practice, people usually use the long-term government bond rate since it is a risk free rate and it is normally quite safe. Now, we look at this table. This table shows that when the discount rate is increased, it will lower the net present value. It will react to the present value of the annual saving. How low can the present value of annual saving will be if the discount rate is high? The manager will see how much the net present value will sustain when the discount rate is high. Okay, that's it from additional consideration. Next, we will go to the post audit of investment projects. This post audit of investment project is actually tells how to monitor and control a project once it is approved and implemented. It is an evaluation of a capital investment's actual performance, which they want to determine whether a project should continually funded or terminated. And this post audit of investment project is actually tell the manager how to give the reasonable and accurate data in determining a proposal. Reasonable and accurate data, and then it also will improve the manager performance in determining the good project or bad project through their past evaluation of any decision making in determining a project. So that's all from me. I'm Nusaibah binti Ahmad. Thank you for watching.